Hello dear students, very good morning. So we are learning the chapter Atoms and Molecules, and today we are going to study about how to write a chemical formula of for simple compounds. To write a chemical formula, you have to know the valency of the atoms, valency of the elements you have to know. Students, look here. So here they have given the valencies of the some of the elements or some of the ions. For example, sodium means, so you know that ions means there must be a positive or negative ions, right? Sodium has positive since it is a metal, and some of the non-metals will have the negative charge. And there are also some polyatomic ions. For example, in nitrogen and hydrogen, it will combine to form ammonium. Next, hydroxide, OH minus, nitrate, NO3 minus, hydrogen carbonate. So hydrogen, carbon and oxygen, these three are there, right? So these are all the polyatomic ions. So here also you can see magnesium Mg2+, and iron Fe2+, and sometimes, so here they will give in the bracket 1, 2, 3, so it shows that their oxidation state will be changing. For copper and iron, the oxidation state or this will be changing. These have a variable oxidation state. Sometimes it will be 3+ and sometimes it will be 2+. Itara irathe. And copper, sometimes it will be in the form of Cu+, and sometimes it is in the form of Cu2+. So if it is 2, it means it has a 2 positive ions. If it is 1, it shows that it has 1 positive ion. The rule that you have to follow while writing a chemical formula as follows. The valencies or the charges on the ions must balance. So idu ions balance agirbek. Next one is, when a compound consists of a metal and a non-metal. Okay, so metal and non-metal, the name or the symbol of a metal is written first. For example, calcium oxide, sodium chloride NaCl, next copper oxide CuO, and iron sulfide FeS. So these are all some of the examples for the compounds. Okay, so how can we write idna yav tara form agutte anodu? So where here this oxygen, in this oxygen, chloride, oxygen, sulfur, so these are all non-metals. They are non-metals. And here calcium, sodium, copper, Fe, these are all metals. So while writing a chemical reaction or chemical formula, so in the right side you have to write the non-metals, and at the first you have to write metals. So here also, take for example calcium, non-metal, oxygen, and we'll take calcium, non-metal, chloride Cl2, right? And copper, it is a metal, non-metal, oxide, or copper sulfate SO4, CuSO4. Okay, so CuSO4. So first we have to write the metal, and then we have to write the non-metal. Again, my non-metals are always should be in the right side. This is RHS and this is left hand side. Okay, so this is left hand side and this is right hand side. So it is always it should be like this. So sodium, iron and copper are the metals and are written on the left side. Students, in compounds formed with a polyatomic ions, the ions is enclosed in a bracket before writing the number to indicate the ratio. For example, calcium hydroxide, right? So hydroxide means OH, right? So hydroxide, we have to write it in the bracket CaOH twice. Okay, so like this, after the brackets you have to write the ratio. So in compounds formed with the polyatomic ions, the ions is enclosed in a bracket before writing the number to indicate the ratio. Okay, so for example, here you have to write the number after keeping the brackets. So in case the number of polyatomic ions is 1, the bracket is not required. Suppose in case the number of polyatomic ion is 1, example OH minus, right? So the brackets is not required for that. Another example for this we can give is NaOH KOH. Okay, so for this, because the polyatomic ion is 1 in case of this, and in case of this polyatomic ion is 2. That's why we have, if it is polyatomic ion is more than 1, we have to use brackets before writing the ratio. But if the polyatomic ions is 1, we no need to write it in the form of KaOH twice like this. It is not required. This is the correct form of writing the formulas.